really want Jesus to be magnified,
amen,
it's important that he gets his due.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. There's more that it should be provided out of our life than I have to fail.
Amen.
I have to be in adultery. I have to be in drugs. Come on now.
Amen.
Jesus paid a price to get more than that.
That's right.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. That should not be the norm.
Amen.
Somebody got to say, Jesus paid a price that we can live the life.
Amen.
Amen. I'm feeling overflow. I'm feeling so under the influence. I ain't going to preach today. No, that's not. Amen. That's not true. But I do want you to sit prayerfully today. I'm glad that we have ministers and preachers in our church who have embraced this faith, because it is universal. Amen. We went into an organization that is not our organization on Friday. We taught there during the day, and we preached it at night, and the message is relevant.
Amen.
Say amen. The message still is relevant,
amen,
which means it's universal.
Right.
It'll preach anywhere.
Amen.
Because
right.
It's the truth.
Amen.
Say amen. It'll preach. It'll stand up anywhere.
Amen.
And I'm just so glad to be a part of it. I don't know what to do. Amen. So we're just grateful today to have a preacher here in our midst that is going to bring forth the message today. I ask you to sit prayerfully and attentively. Ask God to open up your heart of reception. Amen. If we could receive the engrafted word of God, it will build you up. And it will give you an inheritance among all of them that are sanctified. So without further ado, we're going to bring to you the speaker of the hour in the person of Minister Andre, Minister Corey Andre Copeland. Let's receive him with a hearty amen. Can you say it again? Amen. I want you to stand as he comes and just point his way. Just want you to stand and help me and say one thing. Say, preach!
Preach!
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
Amen. It's always an honor to be asked to preach. Amen. It's more so an honor when it's coming from my father, a man who I've seen live this life since I was born and knew anything. He was endeavoring to live for God, and I'm grateful that he has a respect for me, and he would ask me to preach.
Amen.
Amen. It means a whole lot. It means a whole lot. I don't count it lightly at all, and different comments he says to me, I take them to heart. Because I realized he wouldn't say it if it wasn't true.
Amen.
And I want to give honor to him, to the ministers and evangelists and deacons, church leaders, saints and friends, to my beautiful, lovely wife.
Amen.
Amen. She does a whole lot to help. And she truly is a help to me, and inspiration, and she has her own strength that I can get inspired from.
Amen.
I'm going to read from Isaiah 53:1-3. Isaiah chapter 53, verses 1-3.
Amen. Those that have it, say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to ask for you to stand as we read those three verses. For those who don't know, this is a prophecy of the Lord Jesus Christ and what he would do and what he would endure. Amen. In times to come. Amen. We're going to start with verse 1. Who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men. Amen. Let every heart pray. In the name of Jesus, Lord, give your people word that they may stand. Lord, let me preach the truth, Lord. Let me preach the whole truth, Lord. Help me give a word that may uplift and inspire somebody. Help me give a word that open up the eyes of the blind. Lord, we ask these blessings and prayers in Jesus' name. For Christ's sake, let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. My thought is coming from verse number 2. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. And when we shall see him. And I want to take for a title, Seeing Jesus. Seeing Jesus. And we notice that the prophet said, when we shall see him. Not a question about it. Not if we see him, but when we shall see him. Amen. Seeing Jesus. Seeing Jesus. I know that there's a lot of people that become well known in this world, maybe by celebrity status or athletes, or maybe well-known preachers, well-known people that have done great things, and the people, they come to the place where they come to the place where that sometimes the person who admires them, or the person who has a desire for them, they come to the place where they're able to meet this particular person, whoever it may be. They get a chance to see this individual, whoever it may be. And sometimes they are, no doubt, look at the person and say, "You're just like I thought you would be. I've seen you, I heard of you, and I may have seen you somewhere, I heard your words, but now I see you with my eyes, and I see you for myself." And sometimes people, no doubt, they are rejoicing, they go away rejoicing because what they seen in the person was just what they were thinking the person would be. They're content. They felt like that's what it was going to be when I seen this individual. Then there are times where a person that seeks out a certain individual, they get a chance to see the individual. I don't know, maybe they had to travel from to the West Coast. Maybe they had to travel down south. Maybe they had to travel to a foreign country. Maybe the person appeared nearby where they could see them. But They got a chance to see this individual that they had sought after. And once they had seen this individual, once they had an experience meeting and being acquainted with this individual, they found out that the individual is not what they expected him to be. And they found out that, amen, what I thought he would be, and what I expected in my mind for him to be, when I seen him for myself, it was a different story. Amen, things were different. I was disappointed because I was expecting something else. Amen. Is there anybody that had a desire to see somebody in this world before? Amen. Maybe it was Michael Jackson, some of you old timers. Amen. Maybe it was the President of the United States. Especially now, I know Barack Obama is popular. But I think we all can think about a time where it was somebody that we wanted to meet. Maybe a sports individual or somebody athlete. Maybe we didn't get a chance to be acquainted with this individual and see him for ourselves. But when a man or woman chooses to seek God, and when a man or woman chooses to seek out a life that is pleasing to God, when a man or woman decides, I want to change from my ways and I want to cleave to this Bible that I heard about and that the preacher preached about. Amen, I want to change my life. I heard about a man named Jesus that gave his life for my life. I heard about this man named Jesus whom he took, paid the price for my sins, and they hung him on the cross to die for my sins, that I may be saved. I heard about a man named Jesus that paid the price for me. And when we make up our minds, our person, individual, I put it individually, when an individual makes up their mind that I want to live for God, I want to be saved, if you do it with a pure heart, if you do it, amen, with all, nothing, but no wrong moves, no wrong thing, nothing wrong in your mind as to why you want to see this Jesus. Amen. And another thing, you will never get God's attention the way you need to get it without a pure heart. The Holy Ghost just won't fall without a pure heart. There can't be any kind of motive that is because of your own gain or your own glory. But when you get on your knees and ask God to fill you with the Holy Ghost, you got to say, Lord, I want to see your glory. Lord, I'm doing it for your good. But there come a place where you see Jesus. Amen. You see him. You heard the preaching. You've experienced the praise service. Amen. You heard the word of God come forth. You have seen and heard many preachers. You heard about the famous, whatever was popular in that day. Hallelujah. And maybe when you heard the preacher preaching about the baptism of the Holy Ghost and how you got to live holy and how he was delivered from cigarettes and alcohol and fornication, maybe perhaps you got an inspiration in your heart, and maybe perhaps you got excited and said, I want to see this Jesus. He seems like light. He seems like help. He seems like I can be delivered through him. Amen. This man that's preaching this word, amen, it's filled my soul. Believing there is a better life for me. There's a better life for me. There's a way out that this man Jesus has made. I want to see him. I want to get a knowledge of this man. I want to get a knowledge and understanding of this man. I want to see this man named Jesus. There was a man. Amen. And Jesus was the same way Jesus was received today, he was received back then. Sometimes we can read the story and we'll say, why wouldn't these people follow Jesus? But the same way Jesus is received today, he was received back then. There was a man, a young man, that sought Jesus. And this man believed in God. He believed in Jesus. And he sought Jesus. And he came to him. I don't know how long it took him to find him. But he had a conviction towards God. He had a belief in God. He kept God's commandments. He was a serious individual. But the time came when he seen Jesus for himself. I don't know what he was expecting, but he seen him, just Jesus by himself. And I believe the man came there willing to work. He came there willing to do something for Jesus. He was ready to live for him. But when he seen Jesus for himself, he had another testimony. He had another testimony. And we all come to the place, if we seek God in that like manner, that we see Jesus. And as I look at my life, and as I look on the lives of men, I see these scriptures being fulfilled. Amen. Seeing Jesus. Seeing Jesus. People have been baptized in his name and filled with the Holy Ghost, and they go out rejoicing. They go out full of joy. They go out saying, I found the meaning of life. They go out saying, I know what it's all about. I'm content. Thank you, preacher. I'm glad to be saved. Amen. Amen. But somewhere along the line, where they're out there, and the tests and the temptations hit them. And the Holy Ghost is saying, this is the word of life. Amen. We understand the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Amen. When they see this Jesus face to face, amen, there's no beauty that they desire him. Amen. And when they see him for themselves, they say, I expected a man an experience that was going to be glorious. I expected an experience that was going to be sunshine, and I expected an experience that all of my burdens were going to be taken off of me and my way was going to be light. But because of the scripture that says there's no beauty that we should desire him, they don't have enough faith, and we got to have faith enough that says, though there's no beauty that I should desire him, I still believe that God, through his son Jesus Christ, Jesus is beautiful, and I walk with him in the beauty of holiness. There's got to be a faith that goes beyond the rejection. There's got to be a faith that will go beyond the fact that in my mind there's a despise of him, but in my mind I override my mind by faith. I believe that Jesus is able to save me. Seeing Jesus. Amen. Men have seen him and backed up and despise him and say, I don't want nothing to do with this life any longer. But God is looking for somebody that I say, I won't despise him. I'll love him through it all. Yeah, seeing Jesus. Seeing Jesus. Amen. We got to see him.
of God that you can say that though it seems darkness, though it seems rejected, Jesus Christ is light. And the only way we're going to receive Jesus, the only way we're going to receive the word of God is by faith. Amen. We can't do it with our eyes. We can't do it with our minds. Say, our minds will reject them. When we see with our eyes, we reject them. But we got to see through that and walk by faith and not by sight. But Jesus is able. I said Jesus is able to save us if we can believe in him and receive him like the Bible says. Seeing Jesus. Seeing Jesus. Somebody said, I'm waiting for an experience for me to get baptized. Amen. I'm waiting for something to happen for me to change my life. I'm waiting for me to see something good in him. Amen. There's no beauty that you desire him. There's no beauty. There's nothing that makes you want this. You got to want it by faith. You got to believe it by faith. You got to believe it's the wisdom of God by faith. You got to believe it's the knowledge of God by faith. He despised and rejected a man. Despised and rejected. Despised and rejected. Nobody wants anything to do with it. Put it away from him. Every day, hide it. They hide the world, their faces from him. But while the world is hiding their faces, God needs somebody to say, show me Jesus. Let me see him in all of his holiness. Let me see him. I know it represents holiness. Let me see him in all his righteousness. Let me see him in all his commandments. Let me see him though he's telling me to deny myself. Let me see him. I want to see Jesus. I believe though he's rejected, I'm going to receive him. Though they hide their faces. Hallelujah. Men hide their faces from him. They hide their faces from the word of God. People don't receive the word of God. We don't believe in his principles. We don't believe we got to love. We don't believe we got to show mercy. We don't believe we got to turn the other cheek. But that is Jesus. That's Jesus talking to you. That's Jesus telling you to come on. That's Jesus trying to get in you. Amen. We can have our own principles. We can have we got to receive him in our body. We got to receive him in our eyes. That my eyes don't be filled with adultery. The world says this is a natural thing for a man to do. Jesus said, I'll control your eyes. So I'm saying to the Lord, Lord Jesus, control my eyes and control my mind that I don't commit adultery. Amen. I don't want to reject you in that like manner. No.
There's a little rejection there. Amen. The rejection,
There's a little rejection in Christ. I'm not altogether in perfect union with him. I'm not altogether in perfect fellowship with him. I'm not altogether, I don't have a fellowship with the Father and the Son altogether. There's a little rejection there. Hallelujah. Though he saved me when I was lost, though he opened my eyes, I said they were blind. And when I see them with my eyes, there's some rejection there. And Paul came to the place where he said, I'm a wretched man. I'm a wretch. Amen. We got to understand, if we receive Jesus, God through the Son Jesus Christ will perfect that is lacking in your faith. Everything will be complete if we receive Jesus. And you realize the world despises it. The world don't want to hear about a life free from fornication. The world don't want to hear about a life free from adultery. The world don't want to hear about a life where the man can't run with the man. The world don't hear about a life where the woman can't run with the woman. The world don't hear about turning the other cheek. The world don't want to hear about keeping your eyes from adultery. The world don't want to hear about walking in love, even as Christ walked in love. Amen, but that is Jesus. That's him. Men have seen him and despised him. Men have seen him and said, I don't want nothing to do with him. Men have seen him and rejected him and put it far from him. Somebody say, how do you know? It's not in the words, it's in your deeds. It's in your actions. The only reason you still argue with your wife is because you reject Jesus. The only reason you still got hatred in your heart is because you reject Jesus. The only reason you still are racist is because you reject Jesus. They cannot see some sin because you reject Jesus. These are the things that are going to save you if you can receive the word of God in your body and in your mind. We got to do away with our old principles. Whatever it is in your mind, it's not right. Let God put it down by the power of God.
Hallelujah.
got to see him in that light manner. And say, I see him. You're full of light. I need that. I see him. There's no hatred in you. I see it in you. Lord, I'm willing to accept you. Lord, I want to receive you.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Ain't no hatred in God. Ain't no hatred in the spiritual mind, man. There's no fear in the spiritual mind, man. There's no rolling of yards in the spiritual mind, man. Only love, only compassion, only mercy, and great kindness. That's all. That's all that you are. That's all that was in Christ. And you gotta see that and believe it till you receive them. Through the temptation, you gotta receive them. Though the world is rejecting him, you gotta receive him. Men don't believe that you can have the mind of Christ, but you gotta go beyond what man believes. You gotta go beyond until God works in you. You gotta go beyond until God proves to you that it is true. The word of God is true. It'll save you through the nuts and bolts. David's gotta back up. A believer's gotta back up. But the word of God is true. I didn't believe that Jesus would be like this. This kind of church is too serious. I didn't believe that he would put a demand on me like this. This is Christ. This is the word of God. This is how he talks to you. This is what he wants from you. And you gotta overcome. You gotta overcome. I gotta overcome. We all gotta overcome.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sit back, lay back in your seat. Amen. You're not saved until your life. You're not saved as long as you reject.
Hallelujah. Say it again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say it again.
I'm about to have to think about what you want to do when you get out of here. You're not saved until your life. Have to disagree with my words and reject them. You're not saved until your life.
Hallelujah. I'm not worried about what happened in between. Lord, let me have that mind of Christ.
my body, let me receive it.
Amen.
Let me receive it. And I may enter in to the heavenly gates.
Glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This is Jesus. You can't reject this without rejecting Jesus.
Amen.
You can't despise this without despising Jesus.
Amen.
What you receive of this, that's how much you receive of Jesus. Amen. What you reject it, that's as much as you reject of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, my, my, my.
But it's funny that though he despised, Christ is not somebody that you despise. Christ is not somebody to be rejected. There is beauty in Jesus. There he is.
Yes,
amen.
But as long as you're on the outside looking in, you can't help but despise. You can't help but to reject. You can't help but to see something that's not beautiful at all. And now I don't want to do nothing with it. Maybe yet, I'm going to hide my, as you rub my face, I'm going to hide my soul.
That's what it say. My Lord,
my Lord.
Those principles that he talked about, as it were, I'm going to have my faith from you. I'm not going to live by them. I got my own rules up here. But if we can get close enough to God, God is able to tell us his principles. Tell us our morals. Tell us his morals. Tell us exactly how he wants it done. Sometimes the way we deal with our wives, God is able to tell us exactly how he wants it done. And when he tells you, you ain't going to be able to leave nothing. He's not going to give you anything.
Amen.
Anything you're not going to be able to say.
Right.
You can't. Amen.
Amen.
So we got to receive Jesus in our minds and in our hearts. In our minds, we got to receive him. We got to believe that those words are true. Everything else is a lie.
Amen.
You can't believe Jesus and you gotta, that's how you got to believe. This word is true and everything else is a lie. Mama told me to do this, but that's a lie. Yeah, she told me this is how to deal with the situation, but that's a lie. This is truth. You don't choose it together and say, well, I'm going to take that in this. This is the truth. Daddy, Grandpa always told me this is how you deal with a man. This is how you deal with him, and you'll get him off of you. They won't mess with you. If you don't do this, they'll mess with you. If you don't do this, they'll mess with you all the time you're working. So get them straight from the beginning, and then they'll leave you alone. But we need somebody that'll step out on the word of God. And step out on God's word. And step out. Those men despise you. And those men despitefully use you. And say, God will deliver me. I got my own principles that come from God.
Yeah.
I'm not going on man's principles. I'm not going on this one or that one's principles. I'm not living by this one or that one's morals. Let me be God-like. Let me have godliness.
Yeah.
Let me be Christ-like.
Yeah.
Let me be light.
Yeah.
Let me have his holiness. Let me have his righteousness.
Yeah.
Let me have his compassion.
Yeah.
Let me have his love. Those principles. Never let a man use you. That's what my mother always taught me. Well, life has taught me one thing. One thing. If anybody disrespects you, you let them know right away exactly what they did, how they did it, and not to do it again. Those are mama's words. The man said, it's only natural for you to commit adultery with your eyes. The guy I work with, Junior told me that it's natural to commit adultery with your eyes. It's a natural way of a man. And you, what you're doing is foolish. You got to step out. Your wife is going to use you like a rag. You got to be careful about that scripture that says love your wife like Christ loved the church.
Uh-huh.
You'll be doing laundry and you'll be doing everything in the house.
That's true.
But we got to work with that thing. We got to find out what exactly it is until God gives a good balance. Until God gives a good balance. Wife being subjection to your husbands. He does wrong, you got to believe that God is going to give him. You can't go fight your own battle and say, well, no, he's not going to talk to me this kind of way because I know how he was raised and he got this idea about a woman. God's going to give him. God will bless. How can you fail to be blessed if you keep God's word? If you receive him. If you receive him, how can you fail to be blessed? So I'm saying, Lord, help me to receive. Help me to be honest. We got to be honest. We got to be honest. This is a place that Paul found himself in. It's a place that everybody's going to find himself in where they see him. Many people have never been baptized. They're not trying to get the Holy Ghost. They see him. They don't want him. And they don't understand it's by faith. If you can have the faith, God will reveal himself to you. Christ will reveal himself to you. But because you say there's no beauty out of desire, I'm going to stay serving darkness. I'm going to stay in darkness. Hope for the best. But he's despised and rejected. That's something you always got to remember about Jesus. You despise the side of walk with him. He is despised and rejected. He was despised and rejected, and he is despised and rejected. Now, don't think it's strange that people around you don't want to follow him, and that your own self got some resistance against him. But God is able to get in your hearts and in our minds and consume our till every thought is bottom to obedience. Amen. So when we see him, let us get an understanding of what it is in Jesus. And don't be so moved by what you see. Get in him by faith.
Amen.
That you may see. You can't see him unless you're in. You can't see him unless you're in light. These people that despised and rejected him, they were looking from the outside.
Amen.
They couldn't see. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, then we can see clearly. And we can see and understand that God is love. God is peace. My heart can't go into no fearful places. God controls the mind. My mind, God won't let my mind be troubled. Because I let God control my mind. Just bring me under. Amen. So let us walk with God. And let us believe God. And fear God and keep his commandments.
Amen. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a round of praise for that word. What a dynamic word. You know, that sound doctrine right there. Did you hear what I said? That sound doctrine. The world is in trouble on today.
Amen.
Because they rejected and they're rejecting Christ.
Amen.
And he's the conduit that God is using right now.
Amen.
For salvation.
Amen.
People are rejecting him. They want to stay in sin.
Yeah.
Folks don't really want to see him. They don't really want to learn what's in him and know what's in him.
That's right.
Because it causes them to go to another level.
That's right. Amen.
It's a higher calling.
That's right. Amen.
It's in Christ Jesus.
That's right. Amen.
Men and women don't really want this brand because it causes you to move in the different vicissitudes of life